You give up the Jana. I think that Jana Corky would have been pretty strong right there. But then again, IM just has done so well on these more engage-oriented supports. I expect Incredible Miracle to play Leona again this game. Why change what was working already? Tucson had an outstanding game, and it fits their play style.
Well, that's the thing, is I feel like IM is moving away, one of the few teams to move away from really relying on that Jana pickup. It's not really a champion that fits their play style right now.
Right, IM. Yeah. All about those engaged supports right now. Meanwhile, everybody else wanting disengaged supports at the moment here in Korea, prioritizing the Nami, the Jana.
Yep.
And, I mean, Tucson drawing Thresh bans is really a testament to his game impact. Really the only player right now actively having Thresh banned against him. And there's the Jana, and maybe going for the Ezreal as a flex pick. Locks in the Maokai at the last second, so a bit of a mix-up for Shy, and they're going to buy time. Of course, Ezreal did do very well against SK Telecom, actually beating Faker in lane after Ambition camped very heavily for him with Madlife, playing Ezreal into Ahri. So I think he thinks the Ahri is coming out here, but IM's going to hold that mid pick for last, most likely, and try and play the Cassiopeia, I would imagine.
Yeah. You know, it almost feels like CJ wants IM to take Jana because it'll take some pressure off of CJ, even if IM picks that one up.
Frozen.
You know, one of these days we're going to get to see Frozen play Lux again.
Well, if you really want to watch Lux, just watch EDG in the LPL.
Yeah. I want to see Frozen play Lux again, though. It's going to be a while, though.
Jarvan could be the lock-in right here.
I think it's going to be Xerath. Good for Frozen.
Could very well be. They do have the cleanse already lined up, however. And
Well, I stand corrected. I guess my wish is Frozen's command.
Well, this still could be a support Lux. We can't take that entirely out of the equation.
That's a very good point.
I don't know if Tucson plays it, but it is another engaged support that he can use if he's good with those skill shots. It'll be quite effective at providing that crowd control, so could be a flex pick.
I think if you play support Faker, you're going to be willing to play support Lux since she's
better, actually.
So,
champion that Madlife knows very well, very famous support Lux player in his own right.
Way back when.
Yeah, way back when. So, we'll see how they respond to this. If they are going to select the Leona right here. And this is scary, because the thing about Leona Lux together is the passive burst.
Yeah.
It can get pretty ridiculous at times. Those procs can really hurt if they are triggered. And
make CJ.
I think
see
that's
the
smart.
Light.
Take the Azir. Play the AD carry Ezreal, not the best synergy with the Leona, but you can lane swap it and open up Madlife's roaming a little bit, but I do think it's smart. Now, what is Tucson gonna play? Could be support Veigar here again. That's an option. Could be support Lux, and then the mid Cassiopeia up against Azir. This could be a very weird flex pick. I want to see the support Veigar here.
You know,
it would offer a lot of crowd control, and most importantly, you need that peel for Lux, especially when there are champions that can really engage easily onto Lux, like Maokai and like Leona.
Well, Lux is basically kind of like an artillery unit, you know, so if you can get like a big blockade, essentially, that you can do with champions like Jarvan and Veigar, you can allow Lux to do a lot of damage. They might switch it over. We're still not sure where that Lux is going to go. We know Frozen plays it.
I think the Jana
and it will be.
I think the Jana is the best pick right here. That's going to provide the most peel for Lux and Corki. So, Incredible Miracle going for a siege composition this time.
Cool.
They've got good team fighting capabilities, however, with the Narvan combo, and they've got power picks kind of down the board right now.
Wow. Well, it's all on the line for CJ now. I mean, they had that resurgence this season, but if they get 2-0'd by IM, it's all on the verge of just crashing down.
Well, IM has been very steadily improving, though, and you really do have to give them some props as they continue to get better. They took out Jhin Air, which looked like it may have been a bit of an overperformance at the time, but now with IM maybe tying up CJ Entis after a win tonight, if they can pull it out in the next couple of games, that'd be a big statement for them and their improvement over the season.
Yeah, looking legitimate. CJ fans, though, single tier. rolls down their cheek as they realize that their beloved team may have played with their hearts yet again. Oh man. Well,
it's like
here we go.
Spring 2014 all over again.
Seriously. Well, this is it. Can CJ Entis tie it up, get the 1-1, and force a game three tonight? Or will Incredible Miracle get the 2-0? The game is loaded up, guys. It's time to get on to Summoner's Rift and find out. And here we go. Welcome once again to Summoner's Rift. And CJ Entis fighting for their lives here, down a game to Incredible Miracle, trying to tie things up. Shy sending Weird Little Animals running into the forest. But the animal shouldn't. The animal should really just jump onto Shy because he's a tree, right?
Shouldn't they like it? Maybe
the little squirrel bat thing shouldn't be afraid of Maokai.
Yeah, he just wants to kill everybody in the rift so that it can return to nature, right?
Yeah.
He should be quite friendly.
That's right. In fact, Maokai should be able to, like, I don't know, eat those squirrels to regain health or something.
Wow, that's that. No wonder the squirrels are afraid.
Maybe they serve a higher purpose. It's just like in Primal Rage. You ever play the game Primal Rage?
I did.
Yeah, the fighting game where you played like as dinosaurs against each other, and you could, there's like little humans running around on the ground. You could eat your followers to regen health and sanity and stuff. I bet Frozen's too young to play Primal Rage.
Yeah, definitely was.
Probably.
I remember that game growing up in the arcade.
I was the king of that game in my arcade. I played, what was it, like the snake, like make-believe snake dinosaur? I can't remember. Vertigo, that was the name of it. I remember now. Yes. I was the king of Primal Rage.
Well,
and look to what great heights it's taken me.
Yes,
oh, yes.
Truly you have ascended, Noah, to a higher form of existence after your dominance of Primal Rage in backwater arcade in Minnesota.
No, this was Wisconsin, man.
Oh,
this was before I moved to Minnesota. That's true. Yeah, well, some more fans.
All right, we're going to get
really
right back
that,
into this one.
Yeah.
It's like a very minor
here we go.
Hiccup as we start game two, and the Lux is here.
Lilac getting the ward in there. Taking some damage, but you can always recall and come back. No worries there.
Harass him.
Yep.
See if Maokai's going to stack up saplings. He's not going to, looks like, considering he is recalling at the moment. And he'd have to start stacking right now if he wanted to get three in and in time to lane.
Yep.
So.
You ever notice how the sand soldiers like do like a spin when they come out of the ground?
Mm-hmm.
What if they.
It's a pirouette.
We need like a, I don't know, like some sort of dance party Azir skin where they like spin and they like strike a pose when they land.
Disco Azir would be pretty great.
That's right.
The sand soldiers,
they do the like disco point and that's what does damage.
Stay in Azir. Let's go.
That's
Riot, please.
Well, according to the lore, you know, he was like entrapped for a long time and he came back now for like thousands of years. He is literally staying alive for much longer than most people do.
Staying Azir.
That's right.
Another quality skin idea.
You can tell by the way he moves his feet, he's a bird man. No time to, I don't know, no time to miss CS. Like, who knows? Who knows where I was going with that? Forget it.
It's already forgotten. I purged it from my brain already, though.
That's good. You've gotten very quick at that now at this point. It's been a couple of years. Valuable skill. Well, Ambition and Wisdom both starting out at their blues. We'll see where they go from there. I suppose Ambition started out at the Grump.
Well, I'm curious. Again, we have seen that Lux pick out a pawn from EDG in the LPL. Did win that game, but I mean, EDG was heavily favored to win that match in the first place. Their opponents not really on their level, so looked to me at the time like perhaps a little bit of styling, but we have seen.
Well, that is beautiful handwriting, but it's way too small.
Time for Lilac. Well, coming into this one, I'm curious because Frozen has played Lux out of meta before, and he did beat Samsung Blue in Champion Summer with it. So
yeah, he did.
It's not like this hasn't had a great deal of success against good teams previously. He just is a great Lux player.
Yep. I'm excited, man.
So pulling out the pocket pick, perhaps encouraged, and seeing Pawn's performance with it. Or
yeah.
We have seen him hover over.
Oh, Mad Life coming in. There's a stun onto Sunstar, but space not quite there for a trade. Like you said, you know, the synergy, the Ezreal Leona synergy, it's not really there as much as it is with other duos, but you get a good arcane shift. You can do a decent amount of poke if you can follow up on a Leona
yeah,
stun.
It's okay.
It's a bit awkward, though, no matter what.
You don't really have a lot of kill pressure frozen.
Yeah.
Missing a CS right there with his light binding, and it's a lot of poke going on right now. Of course, Flask start for Lux does need that bit of sustain in order to deal with this Azir.
Yeah, really. I feel like mostly for the mana.
Yeah, mostly for the mana, because she does have to use a lot of mana in this matchup, just because without it farming, quite difficult.
Yep.
Those sand soldiers are there.
Always been a bit of a mana hog.
Brutally auto-attack you. Yep. You know, Azir into Jahn is very interesting, because the thing about Azir is his sand soldiers don't get blown away by the monsoon, so you can continue to do damage even through a monsoon, which is a bit of a rare ability, really, to continue to get kind of auto-attack damage in or sustained damage in. Saw that come into play a little bit in the last game.
Nice poking onto Frozen now that Coco has managed to push him back under turret. Catching up in the CS as well.
Yeah, Wisdom.
Here we go.
For a little bit of a jungle invade right now, actually.
The warding begins.
Walking in through the Tribe Rush, may be able to find a gank right here.
There is no vision for CJ there as well, too, so he may have an opportunity. Space and Madlife. There we go, Madlife coming up to the Tribe Rush. Oh, but he puts a ward there. Madlife doesn't get knocked up. They don't quite get any summoners out of it, but
a bit of a sloppy gank there from Wisdom. He could have actually waited that one out. I think he kind of knee-jerk reacted to the ward being placed down, thinking it was going to go into the Tribe Rush. In fact, it did not.
Yep.
Frozen actually auto-attacked Ambition right there with the Gromp buff up on him. Probably not the best idea. Took more damage, really, than he needed to without doing much in response. Now, there is a bit of a duel going on. Lilac getting low in the top side, but Ambition is here.
Shy getting really low here, too. Ambition trying to help out. There's a flash knockup on Lilac, and Shy maybe gets a first blood. Will go to Ambition. It will go to Shy. A little bit of revenge for game number one, and CJ off to a strong start in the initial minutes.
Well, Lilac got sloppy right there. He was engaged very heavily in that duel when they knew Ambition was just in the mid lane, and Frozen should have given him some advance notice that Ambition exited his lane going into the upper side of the river. Now we see some aggression at the bottom.
A lot of damage onto Tucson, and he's going to go down. A kill for Madlife. Space, having not much health, has to burn that flash to get away from Sunstar, but CJ able to snag their second kill of the game. And so far, CJ making plays around the map, and I am really nice, needs to kind of get it together a little bit more.
And Tucson actually died with his flash up right there, so Space aggressively flashing forward. Looks like Tucson was caught a little bit off guard.
We
see the adaptation from CJ in this series. Taking away that Leona and putting Tucson on a more passive support seems to be working out, especially since they banned the Thresh.
With the right combo, too, Ezreal can proc all those, or can explode all those sunlight procs pretty quickly, too. So I think Tucson maybe just kind of underestimating the damage that came in from Madlife and Space there.
They'd already been chunked out a little bit as well.
Yeah,
so
playing a little bit too far up.
All right, well, here we go. Tucson back up. Deep wards will go in the top side. They want to make sure that Gnar can push forward and still deal with this Maokai.
Yeah.
Frozen in the mid lane.
Tucson and Wisdom saying, all right, we're sick of this laning phase stuff. Time to go get
some
kills.
Time to do what we do.
That's
right. Start roaming on the map. But they do it very safely for the most part. And Sunstar returning to base right after pushing that minion wave forward. So not too big of a CS deficit, but Chai and Madlife getting some kills that puts CJ about 1,000 gold ahead at the moment.
Yeah. And you notice Space, too, getting the Sheen and going for that Trinity Force first, not bothering with the tier or anything. I think he learned his lesson from being a little bit underpowered against the Corki last game, so he's just going to pick up that Trinity Force before anything in game two.
Right, and I think that does especially better when he wants to put down some pain in the laning phase also with this Leona, make that threat a little more real and present against Incredible Miracle. Tucson returning right now, Sunstar playing back, so I am will be playing passively, but falling behind this early with this composition, not the greatest thing. Well, the team should be pretty even in the late game, with the exception of Coco, who on his ear is just going to be doing a lot more damage unless this Lux gets absolutely huge. You know, one of the reasons why we don't see Lux very often in competitive play, not only her immobility in lane, which puts her really on par with a champion like Xerath, but she also has the lowest base HP in the game, so very squishy, and then her cooldowns really, really long. So in the late game, you just can't do anywhere near as much damage in a teamfight as an Azir, who will constantly be getting those autos down.
Yeah.
So late game advantage, all things being equal, we have these two big tanks in the top lane and really comparable AD carries.
You know, the
bottom side is going to be that big difference between Coco and Frozen.
You know, the other part too with Frozen as well is that late game, like you said, because of those cooldowns, if he misses one of his skill shots, that's a big chunk of damage that's just not going to get dealt in a team fight too.
Yeah, meanwhile with Azir, pretty easy just to put up some soldiers and like right-click people in the course of a team fight. That part, not too difficult. Of course, Azir, a difficult champion for different reasons. If you want to make some fancy plays with his E and his Q, kind of like while in flight, can get pretty wacky, but...
Coco getting a nice CS lead onto Frozen right now, too. Bit awkward. So, for now, too, IM has kind of given up the Wisdom Tooth and Gank Squad. CJ, meanwhile, is going to go for this Dragon, and IM doesn't really look like they're in a place to stop it. They saw Wisdom up on the top of the map, so should be a pretty easy Dragon for CJ.
Yeah, all Shy has to do is play back right there.
Yeah.
Not really an option for Wisdom to come in. Instead, he will get a ward. Not going to clear out the pink in that brush. Doesn't even check it, in fact. CJ's adapting really well, though. You'll notice that between this game and last game, CJ is placing many more early defensive pink wards right there.
Yeah.
So this looks like they've kind of got IM figured out right now. They've just put those pink wards in their own jungle, knowing that IM was so aggressive.
That sign said, let's go to game three. And at this rate, we'll see. Oh, Space pushed back a little bit, in trouble, and IM claims a nice 2v1 kill there.
I'm not even really sure how that was set up. We'll have to take a look at that, because Tucson didn't even have to burn his flash in order to monsoon Space into the turret.
I know. So. I was wondering how Space got that far in.
Probably Tucson was just like hiding in the lane brush or something like that.
Maybe.
As Space walked up, that must have been it. It's really...
See, I know what Mad Life is feeling right now. He's like, I leave the ward for 2 seconds, and my AD carry just goes and dies. Oh, yeah.
Wow,
right.
Tucson was just lurking in that bush. Space had no
idea. And he used the arcane shift right there, too.
Oh, that is sloppy from Space. Space not having the best day today. Tucson getting the kill.
Yeah, it would have been nicer if that had gone on to Sunstar for IM, but a kill's a kill.
The other thing to keep in mind, too, about these team fights later is that Maokai ultimate is going to be huge for cutting down Corki and Lux's poke. So
yeah.
I really think the late game advantage here again goes to CJ.
Lilac about to be Meganar ambition, trying to set up for a gank, but I don't think Lilac's going to give him that opportunity unless he goes in again here. He does have flash. We'll see. Frozen backing now should be able to finish that Athenes, which he does.
Yeah, pings immediately into the river on the Rek'Sai, so they had a ward, or they had the Scuttle Crab right there. Not going to be fooled, and it's like more conservative play from Incredible Miracle, but with that kill, they draw within 500 gold. Still down that dragon, of course. CJ taking advantage of Wisdom's presence up on the top side in order to safely secure that objective.
It's gonna be nice, but you imagine that IM looks at that first dragon, and they're like, all right, well, that stat boost, presumably by the time it really has a big effect, we'll have gotten our first dragon as well, too. But IM certainly under a lot more pressure than they were in game number one.
And Frozen going for the Athenes again this game. Coco going with the Morella Mamakon. So Frozen just needs some protection against that poke, as well as the engage from Maokai.
Yeah.
A lot of potential magic damage right there.
I don't know if Mad Life is really going to find an angle here. And it is pretty hard to lock down a Corki with Leona, especially when you've got a Janna supporting.
But they can actually make a move onto the blue buff right here. Come a little bit too late.
Yep.
A shade too late on that one. Tucson responding, but Mad Life did have a ward by that tribe rush to see what was going on. Shy clearing out the river, but Lilac not having as dominant of a performance this time around. And both teams trying to play it very conservatively. CJ found themselves in a pretty big hole at this point in the last game, but playing with a lot of poise this time around, waiting for more opportunities instead of kind of forcibly reacting to what was going on in the bottom lane in the last game. I think they had a good draft this time around.
It's made for a really even game.
Yeah, I am trying something a little bit more unorthodox, and I'm not sure it's going to be successful.
You know, IM is, they've certainly improved, but I don't know if they're quite in the position to style on their opponents quite yet. I think the Lux pick was a bit cocky.
No, I do too. I think it was a response to the Ezreal, but CJ does have the ability to flex the Ezreal pick, as we've seen in previous matches, so getting that Lux up against the Azir, not quite as ideal, but they can still make something out of it. IM will have a very strong mid-game power spike. They're not very far behind. They're catching up, actually, in gold as this game goes on. I like doing some work against Shy right there.
I mean, it really comes down to this mid-game siege that IM wants to try to get rolling. And looking at the comp, you know, do you feel like they're going to be able to do it?
Yeah, they should be able to. Just a few minutes right now. Dragon up at 120. I'm not sure Incredible Miracle is going to want to fight this one.
Yeah. Well, this seems like a dragon that you might want to use to try to take down a turret or something like that instead.
Quite possibly. We'll see what their decision is. Try and check the brush right there. They are playing a little scared. They know Ambition's in their jungle.
Yeah, they've got Wisdom to keep them safe for now. Shaib getting really poked out by Lilac.
Notice Ambition playing a bit more aggressively this time around, and that's actually it actually means that there are fewer opportunities for Wisdom and Tucson to get the deep wards in because they're constantly having to react to Ambition's presence. So CJ really actually has, I feel, a good read on what IM was doing in the last game, and they have adapted well so far.
Yeah, they're really setting the pace, I guess you could say, this time rather than having IM set that for them like they did in game number one.
Indeed. Well, Sightstone, second down, onto Wisdom's Jarvan right now. So, see what they do with this. 15 seconds left until this dragon.
Yeah, they want to get some more vision down. Tucson in his own pink ward, so he knows that they can't quite see him. Now they can. Here we go. IM. Well, they spot Madlife. Here comes the dragon. IM wants to contest this.
They want to go for it. Shy is walking down. Lilac will be at the mercy of his teleport.
Yeah.
Actually, Shy making a move back up right now, so.
Oh, they're going to go for it. Okay.
Here we go. Rek'Sai ult coming in. There's an immediate TP.
Yeah, they're going to go back. Solar Flare lands onto Wisdom and Tucson. Tucson taking some damage. Shy activates that ultimate. True Shot Barrage comes through. Lilac, they have to save Sansari. Valk's over the wall. Shy just not taking a lot of damage here. Nice knockup. Azir Wall comes through as well. Two people push back. Madlife pops that ult for, or Tucson rather, pops it up for just a second. Nice knockup onto Tucson. Ambition comes in. Have they set up the first kill? The fight they have. Space takes it. And CJ, can they turn onto this dragon or have they been too poked out? I am still threatening here. CJ wants to try to get this dragon, but this may be a bit dangerous. Wisdom extremely low, though, and no ult. I think I am may have to just give this one up. We'll see how the poke from Frozen and Soundstar works.
They're really trying for this one, though.
They're going to try to burst it down. We'll see if Frozen can take it. He doesn't have his ult. No. Wow. So I am just kind of milling around there. I feel like they maybe could have put some pressure on the mid lane. There was really no chance they could stop that dragon after they lost Tucson.
Well, right there, too, what happened was Lilac teleported in, but his ult was still on cooldown.
Yeah.
Looks like he was dueling a bit with Shy up on the top side, and he's used it previously. So Incredible Miracle could have just left that alone, like you said, and actually just pushed down the top side tower and gotten teleport advantage. So a bit sloppy from them for sure on that one. Didn't look very coordinated around the Gnar ultimate being off cooldown. Yes, he was in Mega Gnar form. No, he did not have his ult available was the issue.
Yeah. Well, it's a little bit odd because we see IM with a different comp, but they're still playing it like the last one, you know?
IM, looks like Zonstar does get a bit caught out on the backside space, doing a bit of work. Shy getting right into the mix, and Wisdom tries to get out of Coco, is immediately denied due to the Azir wall. Frozen burned his ult very early on in this, so he just didn't have very much follow-up damage, and issues that you have with this Lux is you're just so much more limited in terms of what you can do compared to Azir.
Yep. And they're not quite able to hand that blue off. Frozen having to take the long way around. Wisdom extremely low, and there we go. They get the blue buff over to Frozen at the last moment. CJ still hasn't taken any turrets off of this, despite grabbing both of the first two dragons.
That's a good lead for them, though.
Very good lead.
Feel confident with their dragons in this game.
Yep, the gold.
They have the scaling advantage. They have the dragon advantage, so they will be able to force fights the longer this game drags. Oh,
whoa!
He stole it!
Did he?
Yes.
Okay.
No,
he didn't. Yeah, I didn't think so.
Oh, Coco
yeah.
got it. It was so close, though.
Yeah. Well, nice try. That is a fairly low cooldown ultimate, so though, you know, although Frozen didn't have it available to try to snipe the dragon after that last team fight, had it for the blue buff steal attempt.
It's only going to be about 35, 40 seconds on that.
Yeah. Whoa, Frozen takes some damage and Ambition and Coco over the wall. Frozen tries to get away, gets knocked up after the flash, after the cleanse, and Frozen ganked by CJ Entis. And that could mean a mid turret gone.
Great setup there
yeah.
from CJ. Punishing him as he was going over that pink ward, and Coco will take the tower in response. So CJ's rolling now. Don't think this is going to be a situation where Incredible Miracle is easily able to come back. Ambition pushing forward alongside with this Azir, and they're going to get two for it. Huge
wow.
punishment. So they back themselves up with the Sun Disk Azir passive. Coco trying to get as much farm as he can in the interim. This Lux pick really not working for Incredible Miracle.
Yeah, suddenly about a 3,000 gold lead now for CJ as well, too. They are definitely starting to pull ahead.
Yeah, and when we're talking about a 3,000 gold lead, and you have two dragons,
yeah.
and you have the late game advantage in terms of composition, gonna take a lot for Incredible Miracle to come back right here.
Very true. Looks like IM could lose another turret here in the bot lane. Space doing a lot of damage to it. Meanwhile, the top lane goes down in favor of IM, so at least they do get one objective out of this.
Yeah, but they may lose three when the dust settles.
Yep.
And that is a pretty shoddy trade for Incredible Miracle.
There it goes. And they're going to keep chasing here. Solar Flare not quite able to connect with anyone. But CJ's okay with that. They just needed to zone a bit to finish off that turret.
So now for Incredible Miracle, they're in a situation where they should be hitting their power spike right now. But when you have like a quirky Lux combo, you have these mid-game Siege champions, you're in a world of hurt when you lose your outer towers first, because now you have to extend so far down the lane, and it just becomes insanely unsafe, especially against a champion like Rek'Sai that can get behind you if she has any tunnels in your jungle and flank you immediately. There's no real backup right here, and it becomes ludicrously difficult
yep.
to win this game for IM based on their emphasis on Siege and their mid-game power spike. They can't take advantage of it right now. CJ can just play back at their turrets, push the lanes up when they're able, never really suffer the brunt of the Siege, because IM just isn't going to feel safe moving far enough out of their base to put sustained pressure onto a turret.
Yeah. You know, early on, it seems like they had an opportunity here and there to try to get some sort of Siege going, but, you know, they wanted to contest that dragon. I feel like, you know, they picked this other comp, but they're not playing it like a Siege comp. They're trying to play it like, you know, they're team fighting or something again.
They can team fight with this comp as well. The foolish part was, I agree that they should have just assaulted the turret, the mid lane turret in that circumstance, but they can team fight, of course. They do have Gnar, Jarvan, and Janna. That is very strong in that regard, but they didn't have the ultimate up for Gnar. That's the big kicker right there, as well as a bit of a sloppy engage in space, chunking out Sunstar very early on in that engagement. But now the power spike is going to be completely missed from Incredible Miracle, and should not be terribly difficult for CJ to close out. They need to advance their ward line, though. It is a bit conservative at the moment, especially considering that we have 15 until this next drag.
Yeah.
Bad timing, too. Lilac transforming into the mini Gnar.
Oh, he's got a minion wave to try
about
to build it back
seconds.
Up again.
Well, but he's going to be tired, so he can't actually
yep.
until for a little bit longer.
15 seconds, and then he can start building again.
Not good. Dragon is alive. Azir is walking down right now, so they can take Hook a bit late.
Yep. And CJ going for Dragon number three. They activated Coco, doing some damage. Ambition coming in as well. Shy there to zone. Lilac, again, so far from that Meganari, he's just not going to be really able to be much of a part of the scene. By Shy, jumps in. Big knockup comes in from Tucson. The man life right there. Tucson pushing people away. Lilac on his own. Sansar has to get away before doing a whole lot of damage. And Wisdom on the run as well. Lilac, so tanky. He zones out space. Shy over the wall, though, zoning out most of IM. But Sansar still doing some damage in this long team fight. Finally goes down. A kill, though, comes in for CJ. But IM has done enough damage. They've managed to prevent the dragon. No, they didn't prevent the dragon. What am I even talking about?
CJ it did go actually to CJ after did all. Get the dragon.
Wow.
Super risky. Ambition didn't have smite.
Yeah, I'm actually really surprised they got that.
This was actually not a good dragon. So we can see right now, wow, that Ambition didn't have smite for that. They actually had to just burn it all the way down. And when you're facing a Corki and a Lux, that does get a bit dicey. So Lilac comes in right now. We do see Randomance going down. Everybody from CJ a little bit bunched up. Shy on the high grounds. Coco changes his focus to dealing some damage up higher. They push Lilac away, and unfortunately for Frozen, the ult only hits Mad Life and Coco. They're not killed by
Ambition.
Ambition takes a bunch of damage, but gets the shield from the face of the mountain. And so,
will Mad not Life be going dying. Deep. Tucson going nearly down. Will they get him? Solar Flare comes in, and there's a kill for Coco. They may be able to grab more. Coco, though, evaporated by Frozen's ultimate. Lilac, just not very tanky at the moment. He'll eventually get taken out by space.
Two CJ, for one, Ambition is back, however.
Yeah, ulting in. They're going to be able to take more control of this jungle, maybe take this tier 2 turret as well.
Yeah, he wants to move around, start zoning out with Mad Life. He's going to get it. They're going to get a tower, so another one fight from CJ. CJ bouncing back. And I just can't. I really like the way CJ played this game out. I think they adapted so well, not only in terms of their composition, and yeah, this Lux really isn't doing work, so not sure how serious IM was in this game.
Yeah.
But you have to look at the way they played this game, too. You have to look at how they changed the locations of their pink wards, how they got the earlier pink wards out. I'm sure their coach said, okay, here's what they're doing. IM is getting way too much deep vision right now. Just try and clear it out a bit earlier on. You guys need some earlier pinks, and you need to place them defensively. And then Incredible Miracle can no longer make these aggressive plays with Tucson and Wisdom safely. You shut down a lot of the gank squad right there. Of course, the Leona takeaway, huge in this game, because now Tucson just can't be that playmaker that his teammates have relied on. So I like the change to the draft. Ban out the Thresh, take away the Leona, and it's really working out for CJ.
I'd agree. Good adaptions, or adaptations, I should say. And I am kind of in dire straits here in game number two. They've managed to take two turrets, but no dragons. Not a lot of kills. CS still staying fairly even, but it really is more about the dragon buffs at this point, the map control that CJ has gained. So if you're IM, though, I mean, what do? You kind of, I feel like you have to find CJ in the wrong place, either get picks or wait for them to get out of position, try to win a team fight too.
Yeah, unfortunately, both teams are running like poke and siege compositions, so the fact that CJ has a poke advantage is pretty massive right now in terms of how this game is likely to play out. There's not really a great way for IM to come back into this one, especially because they do have the inferior poke in the late game. I just don't see a lot of hope unless somebody from CJ really gets caught out, and that leads to surprise Baron from Incredible Miracle. That could turn things around, but otherwise I don't think they're going to be working with much. Coco actually going for the heavy hitter Azir build this time around. Not building the Stinger, but going straight into the Death Cap. Now, this will spike his damage should he choose to E in. But otherwise, his sustained damage over the course of the team fight not going to be quite as high as if he had a Stinger.
True enough. But, you know, when you've got champions like Janna and Lux on the other side, you know, just a few hits are enough to really poke somebody out.
You could probably actually one-shot Lux right now.
Yeah, it's possible.
ambition, doing a good job of threatening with the split push. You can see Hex Drinker, the Rek Sai of this game. Good pickup, adds a little bit of extra damage, and especially against the quirky Lux, it's going to do a lot of work in terms of that magic resistance and dodging after the poke. Use that final spark to clear the wave. Is a lot of damage. Look at how fast the Azir clears the tower.
Yeah. And the thing is, too, is that Shy can kind of just show up whenever he wants and just tank the turret for a little bit, too. But all the other turrets are down now. So you got to deal with those inhibitor turret lasers from here on out.
Yeah, CJ trying to bait the Baron, but it's not very threatening when Rek'Sai's on the bottom side, but they are actually going to go for it. Of course, that Rek'Sai ult can come in at any time.
Yep.
Looks like they're going to try. Here we go.
Yep, coming right into the Baron pit. Hello.
Sneaky.
And I am. Can they contest the Solar Flare used really early? There's Baron. Can they get it? Oh,
he
Frozen managed
it.
To steal the Baron. Can they win the fight now? I am. A lot of damage onto CJ. Lilac coming in. Huge ult against the Baron pit, but Space responds with a kill. Can I am follow up? The ult comes through, and Frozen with another kill onto Madlife. Tucson coming in. Can he stop anyone from getting out with a Whirlwind? The flash from Shy. Tucson coming in with his own flash.
Space,
Whirlwind
no
onto
mana.
Space. Space exhausted as well, too. He's going to go down. I am gets the Baron. They get the kills. The fans going crazy now. What can IM get out of this? They can get the dragon, they can get the mid turret, anything else?
Yeah, they get tier two in mid
I guess so.
Well, Doa,
wow.
They're gonna get dragon out of it too.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, speaking of miracle barons, there's one for you. Frozen didn't even steal that with his ult.
No, he didn't. He got it with like an E or something.
Yeah, wow. Okay, well, Incredible Miracle gets right back into this one because they don't actually secure that Baron, and now the Dragon going the way. Huge swing in momentum here for Incredible Miracle. Lilac coming in with a big ult as well.
Don't know if they Ambition can... Shy want to tangle with this here. There's a light binding coming in from Frozen. Lilac trying to get away. No flash for him right now. Oh, they stun him with the Solar Flare, and CJ is going to at least come away with this or from this with a kill.
And a blue,
and
buff,
a blue buff
as well.
All right.
At the end of the day.
Oh, Wisdom. Got to be careful there.
Oh!
Did he get it?
No.
Coco got it.
Coco got it. Well, that's a huge takeaway on the Dragon, too.
Yeah.
I am buying themselves some time. Still with... What is Wisdom doing?
I really don't know. He was trying to make sure he got the Wolves or something, but I don't think that's really worth it. No flash, and he's just going to donate himself to CJ. I don't know. That was not a good place for Wisdom to be there. That was just a plain old mistake. No way. No,
game
no debate on that one.
Game getting a little throwy right now.
It certainly is. Nice loosened singularity coming in from Frozen there for the damage, but CJ still going to put the pressure on against a Baron-powered IM team. CJ still going to take that inhibitor turret.
Well, they still have a man advantage, so they should be going
knock up onto space. Getting chipped away. Yep.
Wow, I'm actually...
Oh, Madlife! Getting caught, getting taken out! Luxall comes through, nearly takes out Coco. Oh man, if he had had a Leandries, that would have been a dead Azir. Sunstar coming in. Space taking a lot of damage here too. Gets hit with the rocket. There's the Azir turret.
Yeah, how far are they gonna push this? Looks like they're not gonna go any further at this point. Take the Azir turret while you can. You already have Baron powered minions right there.
Yep.
But that's it. I won't be able to do anything more. Let's take a look at this again because
crazy
Frozen. It's an E. Takes it with the 80 right there because the binding was used on two members of CJ. Wisdom comes with the Cataclysm. Look at that, actually. The Janna ult forced them all to the edge of the Cataclysm. Nice CC, and then the follow-up from Lilac. It was very well-chained CC from Incredible Miracle.
Yeah.
And then a bold play from IM. Moving forward, falking over that wall. Sunstar coming in. Space just not able to do anything right there without any mana.
Ambition, the issue there, using his smite a little bit too early.
Well, still CJ's game to lose, really. Even after all those...
They're trying their best.
...shenanigans.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot gained from that scenario. Yes, they lost the Baron, but... And a dragon. And two towers, but...
That's
they were
kills.
So far away, so far ahead. And they still have that late game power. That it should be okay. Although Frozen is getting a little bit dangerous to Coco right now.
Yes.
And as we can see, Coco is building into a cowl. Banshee's Veil will pretty much stop any threat from Frozen, however.
Yep. Very true. Probably going to see a couple of Banshee's Veils across the board from CJ Antis. And now they have to kind of regroup after that kind of scary situation.
Yeah, that's the other thing about Lux and her long cooldowns is that she is pretty hard countered by Veil, because if you cut out one of those loosened singularities or a light binding, she just doesn't have enough additional damage to finish you off after that. So
yeah, there's a reason we don't see her a whole lot, and these are those reasons.
Unless you have like 20 Medjai stacks, which honestly you kind of need in the ultra late game. And we don't see a Medjai yet, so really Frozen not going to be stacking that up particularly quickly.
Yep.
CJ now looking to pressure. The Baron buff is off, and they have that naked inhibitor to play with, but there's a lot of wave clear coming through the gap.
And 2 minutes till that next Baron now. 2 minutes until the dragon as well, because they were taken by IM at about the same time. CJ, though, really wanting this bottom inhibitor. Getting that would be the perfect pressure to put on before they try to take this next Baron.
That's what they want.
Yep.
See, they are moving ever so slowly with each wave through the choke point.
Yeah.
And blocking it off.
Oh!
Oh, that's actually huge.
Yeah, that was a late ult from Frozen, and that's going to make it really hard to defend this inhibitor now. Lilac is about to go Meganar, though. They may be able to make something out of this. We'll see Wisdom coming in from the side, gets poked away by the Sand Soldiers from Azir. Coco trying to create some space there. They're going to rotate maybe to the mid lane here.
CJ playing this very passively right now. They're afraid of making another mistake like they did at the Baron, and they don't want to overcommit to anything. Frozen's ult will get back up, though. Actually, the Meganar did buy them some time, but there's a large, large minion wave developed up in the top side that needs to be cleared out. CJ could find a window.
Frozen's ult's up again. Wisdom still getting poked out by Coco. Wisdom has been trying to find an angle to trap people in the Cataclysm. Set some stuff up, but it just has not happened yet. They're going to send Sansar over, and that's going to cause CJ to come in. Shy with the ultimate. Can they stop themselves from losing this inhibitor? Wisdom flashes in, tries to get into space on the back lines, but gets locked up with the solar flare. Luxalt comes in as well, does some damage, and CJ being pushed back. Lilac in the back lines onto Ambition and Coco. Shy has to exit the base. Frozen looking for that kill, but Sansar will be the one to take it, and CJ pushed out of the base. The inhibitor defended for IL.
Okay, well,
pretty incredible.
They tried to take advantage of the fact that Sonstar was over there clearing out the wave in the top side, and
yeah,
CJ wanted to go in. They couldn't get quite the right engage, and Wisdom bottling enough people up that they're able to finish off Shy in the end, who is still working on a bit more tankiness here.
He's getting really tanky already, but CJ just can't quite seem to get in there yet.
Ambition roaring in with the home guard boots off of the Rek'Sai ultimate just to make sure that Lilac can't take control over the Baron. It has respawned. Dragon up as well right now. CJ could look for number four. They could trade number four for a Baron, but
definitely
a hard call. And they're pinging very actively onto this Dragon right now. They want to be put in that situation where they can force a fight and end the game at the next Dragon.
I think forcing a fourth Dragon stack in a trade for the Baron against a team that's as far down as I am is probably a safe
it's
trade
fine.
For CJ to make.
Yeah, exactly, because then they can force, and in fact, they don't even
they
have
to. They get
to
contest, yeah.
IM was busy clearing out their lane, so the minions didn't take out the inhibitor, so now CJ may well get both, and IM on the ropes. They can't give up another Dragon in 6 minutes.
Yep.
So, basically, CJ will be able to force the fight that they want out in the open, where this Gnar is going to be much less of a threat, where they won't have to cluster for Lux damage.
This inhibitor may be in trouble here. Lilac trying desperately to get back the energy to go into Meganar. Getting a little bit of that from the boomerang.
And CJ still not wanting to go in. They would be well served by the Baron buff right now, but IM got enough wards around it that they have the possibility of a contest. Looks like Frozen's gonna go for the Zonya's Hourglass next. Scuttle Crab in favor of IM right now as Ambition and Wisdom square off around this red buff. Frozen will come in for a little help. Ambition not going to be able to take it out, just tunneling quickly right back into Baron pit.
Yep.
Oops. Tucson moving that ward on him, actually. That was clever. It is cap for wards right there.
Yep.
And forced the lens to be used after the pink ward was already put down. All right, so where are we going with this one?
Well, CJ just kind of milling out around right now, really kind of, I think, afraid after what's happened to them with that Baron, with trying to push in for that inhibitor. They're suddenly playing things much, much more cautiously, and with all of IM up, with the pressure on the lanes not being as severe as CJ would like, it makes it tough to go for this Baron.
Yeah, Lilac doing what he can to keep that inhibitor safe.
Yep.
With his teleport up. See what the play is going to be. CJ is really a no threat right now, so they can drag out this game and play it safely. It's probably the best move for them.
They can literally just wait until the next dragon if they want to.
Right, and that's the tipping point right there. That's where I am. Unquestionably must fight them, or else they will lose the game.
Yep. CJ though, wow, they're gonna turn onto that Baron. Managed to catch IM away from it, so CJ just gets a free Baron. No other way to really say that. Tucson getting caught, knocks up Madlife as Madlife tries to come in. And here we go, Lilac trying to get away, really getting poked. They've got to be careful here. Madlife getting chunked up pretty well. CJ, they've got the Baron buff now.
And they should just move bottom, leave Shy in the mid lane, and that's what they're going to do.
Yep.
Just to keep the minion wave and empower those minions with the Baron buff. CJ chasing backwards a little bit. They'll clear this out quite quickly with Ezreal in his ear and march on forward towards that inhibitor that has been tormenting them for quite some time so far this game.
Yep. Well, they've got the Baron buff. They've got what they need to presumably take this inhibitor. Frozen's still there, though. Let's see if they can do it. Here we go again. CJ pushing in. Tucson's just going to try to create some zones with those whirlwinds. Any knockup could mean some decent poke. Oh, speaking of poke, Lilac taking a lot of damage from those sand soldiers. Uh-oh. And this inhibitor is looking like it's going to be gone. Nothing IM can really do about it. Inhibitor down to about half health. Meanwhile, Rek'Sai takes his top turret. Lilac can't stop him. There goes the inhibitor. And CJ just going to back out, rotate to mid. Ambition still putting pressure on the top lane, and IM just kind of collapsing under the pressure now. There's just not a lot they can do to prevent CJ from pretty much walking wherever they'd like to at this point.
Ambition has done a really good job of split pushing this game.
Ambition's got Flash.
Yeah, Flash out of that one. Was trying to wait for his tunnel to come back up, but saw the Lux binding en route and decided better of it. Now, nobody here to defend at least the first couple of attacks onto the tower.
Yep.
And Ambition recalls, heals up with the home guard boots, and then immediately gets himself into the mix one more time with the Rek'Sai tunnel. And it's one of the powers of Rek'Sai, really, is you're able to split push because you can always just appear right back next to the rest of your team.
Yeah.
You have your ultimate available and ready to go. So Ambition, after taking that tower, trying to use these Baron minions one more time to make a move here.
Ranger.
Not the best true shot barrage. And Space gets hit
oh,
by
they
Vine.
Caught Space, and they're just going to evaporate him. Frozen with a lot of damage there. Oh, Space. Shy has to burn that flash solar flare, but it's only a defensive one as CJ backing away. Space in the wrong place at the wrong time, and he just gets disintegrated by incredible miracle.
Really poor Whoa. Positioning from Space.
Yeah, no kidding.
Right there. I mean, you can't, if you're playing Ezreal, you can't allow yourself to be caught by a Lux binding like that when you have so many escape tools. He had his flash up. I think he had his arcane shift available as well.
Well, that's just simply not paying attention.
Well, I mean, Madlife also had Crucible, so yeah. There's that aspect of it as well. Pretty poorly played team-wide, but good reaction there from Frozen to combo his abilities. You have to be careful. Lux can get you through the even through your front line, but
well, it's getting a bit scary too. I mean, that ult is going to be up so often for Frozen now as well.
And now Lilac and crew have a timing window under this dragon. They can deny. Oh man, are they going to deny the fifth?
They need to deny this one. If CJ gets this, and Coco tries to poke him, but he can't quite do it. Meanwhile, Ambition and Madlife take out the mid inhibitor turret. Recalls coming in from IM. But all inhibitors are vulnerable now.
I wonder why they took out the turret instead of heading up and taking out the actual inhibitor up in top.
That's a good question.
And it may have been a better use of their time, but they get it anyway. I suppose they had help of the minions in the mid lane, so they may have just gone for the 100% thing rather than risking it right there. But
I mean, CJ knows they can stretch this game out. Again, you know, yeah, it's embarrassing when space gets caught like that, but it really doesn't change a whole lot. Because CJ can make this game go as long as they need to, really.
They can. But it's still disheartening that CJ has made some pretty large errors in this game, which have given IM a glimmer of hope.
Yeah. CJ definitely not playing this one perfectly. And IM doing a good job of taking advantage of those mistakes to bring themselves about as far back into this game as you could expect them to.
Yeah,
maybe even a little bit more so.
Still 7K behind because of CJ's very dominant early game and their ability to snowball. They've just made a couple errors at crucial points in time that have extended this match.
Yeah, close game across the board. Lilac taking a lot of damage right before Meganar. There goes the mid inhibitor, and yeah, I am. You know, again, we never know what's going to happen. There could be a crazy team fight. Space could get caught, but it looks like for now, CJ has got all three inhibitors. Wisdom trying to come in and make a play. He's going to get taken down fairly quickly. Oh, actually, no. Gets up for the moment. Ambition back. Oh, there's a kill. Oh, actually, Ambition's taking the turret. I don't know what's going on. Wow, Lilac. All of Ion being forced back. What can you say, CJ? They've got the four dragon buffs. They've got the damage. Coco just Zonia stays safe. Oh, maybe not that safe. Never mind. Rosen laying that loosened singularity trap for him.
Right, and they're not able to finish up right
now.
With everybody coming back to full HP. Space trying to make it work right here. He wants to get onto Frozen. He's exhausted, though, and Space.
That was a bit overeager. Space trying to stay alive.
Oh, they got Sonstar.
They did get Sonstar, but I am still fighting this really to the bitter end. This has been, as CJ looks like they may clean this one up finally. Wisdom still going through. Wow. So I got to say, this has been one of the more sloppy late games that we've seen. These team fights have not been pretty.
Well, CJ, I think, did the right thing there. Yes, Space died, but they actually forced the game to be ended immediately just through a little bit of brutal, ugly brawl at the end. Took out Sonstar, really their only hope of defending their Nexus.
Yeah, only Wisdom
and with
left.
That,
despite the Iron Elixir, despite the Nox. Oh, he gets Ambition at the end.
CJ just doesn't care. They're just going to throw bodies at the inhibitor until they get it.
Wisdom going for the double kill. He doesn't care anymore. Oh, doesn't quite get it. There it is. GG. We're going to game three, and CJ wins it. Yeah. I guess you just need to become the battering ram sometime, don't you?
Sometimes,
that last fight, I'm like, I don't know.
Sometimes you just have to be like Ulysses S. Grant and just throw people into the meat grinder at the problem until it's solved.
I guess so.
And they did just that at the end. It wasn't pretty, but it was effective.
Well, I am. You know, again, I really think that one you have to give to CJ's.